G'day guys, Jono Lester here, back home from the final round of the New Zealand Endurance Championship, about to cut some laps in one of my trusty training tools here. But first, a wrap from the final round of the New Zealand Endurance Championship down in Timaru over the weekend. This was the first event that Tras Family Motorsport were running as a standalone outfit. We'd broken away from our previous team and were running our own show in preparation for the Highlands 101 coming up next month. So we had a very quick turnaround of really only a week in between events to get all of our infrastructure together and get the car all prepared for the big event. But as it turned out, it all went really, really well. I had a new co-driver for this event, which was my good friend Hugh Gardner, who was leading the 1 hour points for the New Zealand Endurance Championship in his Porsche. But unfortunately, on the test day, Hugh had to withdraw. He's 6'3" and a bit tall to actually get his head in the car without hitting the roof. So it was back to normal with Robin Gray beside me for the final round, as we had done for the first two rounds, and Robin applied himself really well and did a great job. Really, our only issue on Friday was trying to stay out of the sun and not get burnt, because it was just beautiful weather down there in Timaru. They really know how to turn it on, good and bad at times, as we found on Saturday. But the car ran well, testing all went fine, made a few little changes to the car to suit the circuit, but we felt that we had closed the gap to the cars up the front on the tight, twisty circuit. Into Saturday morning, there was rain on the forecast, but at that point in time, it didn't look like it was going to be there until the middle of the afternoon. So, two dry qualifying sessions, and honestly, I wasn't very happy with how we got on. The car didn't feel brilliant. I was suffering a lot with the balance and with trying to actually get the most out of the tyre. We only qualified in sixth place, and I was a little bit wary about how we would fare come race time based on that performance. Into the one-hour race, Robin and Gerald drove the car for that and got a season best fourth place, did a brilliant job. Also gave Robin some more seat time ahead of the 3 hour, which really helped us come the afternoon when the rain did come. The 3 hour race started dry. I started the race and managed to work my way up from sixth to first. Had some great battles with Graham Smythe, a good friend of mine in one of the Porsches. Also with one of the Carter boys in their wicked V8 supercar. And handed over under safety car at 40 minutes from the lead. Robin then did his stint, and the rain could not have come at a better time. Within the last sort of 10 to 15 minutes of his run, the rain started just to slowly fall, and the track gradually got damper and damper, and he pitted at the hour mark for him and threw me back in the car for an hour 20 remaining with a set of wets on to charge for the win. With the way we worked the strategy and with our increased pace relative to those around us, we were able to rejoin under safety car from that pit stop in second place. I had Craig there in front of me and Pedersen, the points leader, in behind me. And it was to be a bit of a tussle for the last hour. Into the restart, past Beato into the first corner, and managed to hold that for a couple of laps, but really didn't feel the car was brilliant in the damp conditions. So Craig ended up ducking up the inside of me around the back of the circuit, and Amp soon followed. And I settled into third place for about 15 to 20 minutes, and the rain gradually got worse and worse and worse, and as it did, our car really just came to life. So I was able to chase Ed down and pass him, and then chase Beato down, who was another few seconds up the road. And the final 15 minutes of the race were just epic. Zero vision, fogging up windows, nothing, couldn't see a thing, very, very dangerous, but also huge amount of adrenaline, as you can imagine, and I was able to really put pressure on Craig to try and find a way past for the lead. With 15 minutes to go, I made a move around the outside for the lead of the race onto the back straight, and unfortunately was tapped into a spin when I was finishing that move. Full 360 somehow kept the car on the track, kept going, lost about 50 to 60 metres. But it was at that point also that the officials deemed the race to be too wet and too dangerous to continue, so they called it there, then and there. Overall, I'm pretty happy with the second place. I mean, we've really not been even remotely competitive the first two rounds with the more wide open circuits, and this really gave us a chance to let the 430 come into its own, both with weather and also with the nature of the circuit. We were definitely the quickest car out there in the wet. Just didn't quite go our way, and there's a little bit of damage on the left rear corner to prove that. But very happy, very happy. It gives us a great platform to move into the Highlands 101 in 3 weeks for, where we'll be debuting our new car, which I look forward to unveiling over social media and what have you at the end of the month, the end of October. Make sure you get down to Highlands if you're a southerner. The Laser Girls will be there in force supporting what we're doing. doing some giveaways and some competitions and what have you. And obviously we'll be out on the track. I'll be competing in three different events over the course of the weekend. The Euromark Racing, the Australian GT Round, and also the 101 lap endurance race on Sunday. It's going to be a huge weekend of motorsport in what I believe is the most spectacular circuit in this country by a mile, although I'm yet to view it and I really can't wait. So look forward to seeing some of you there, and thank you for the continued support, and bring it on. Thank you.